So before Raw begins, I just want to explain to you how Universe will go, because it's not going to be how everyone else usually does it. So it's going to go like this month, which is September. Class of the Champions is coming up. It's going to be all Raw. It's Raw only. SmackDown will have next month, which is October. And I'm not sure if it's gonna be Hell in a Cell or not, because I don't really want that. The reason it's like this is because, one, because I just kind of want to be different with it, and two, it's a little easier on me just to do one show a month. But I guess it kind of keeps things fresh a little bit, you know? But then when there's two teams, or not two teams, when there's like a pay-per-view where there's two, when there's two, God, what the hell, when there's a pay-per-view, when the two shows are together, there we go, like Survivor Series or SummerSlam, Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, you know, then, we'll all be seeing these together, but I'm not sure if it's gonna be week one Raw, week two SmackDown, or week one Raw and week one Raw. Like, I'm not sure how I'm going to do that just yet, but we'll see when we get there. And pretty much by the time Survivor Series comes, I think WWE 2K17's out, so I won't have to play this game much longer, but we'll see. So anyway, I just wanted to explain that to you guys so you don't get confused on why there's no SmackDown. So anyway, I hope you enjoy the show. Welcome everybody to Monday Night Raw. We are live in Baltimore, Maryland. Starting off with our first match, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus, who I think he's only been in one match so far. He went up against Cesaro and won in an excellent match. So, while these people are coming out, I do want to tell you guys that there has been some injuries at SummerSlam, to three people, actually. Two aren't so bad, and one, it's pretty bad. The one is from Raw, our very own, and, he has a ruptured eardrum. Like I said, it's not too serious, so, he should be back within one of these episodes. Just to let you guys in on why he's not there. The next one is actually the next two are from SmackDown. One is Sasha Banks. She has a back injury. She doesn't need to have surgery, thankfully, so she should be back by the time SmackDown airs. And last but not least, we have Finn Balor. And we're going to show you the clip of how he got hurt. It's brutal, ladies and gentlemen. Ref is down, so if anyone went for the pin, they can't do it. Oh my god. Oh my god! He landed on Finn! He landed on Finn Balor! Oh my god! Darren Young now getting ready for action. His debut match on Monday Night Raw and in this Universe mode has a huge opportunity to go up against Sheamus. Now, how this is going to go is because I'm not going to watch all of these matches. I'm going to be in some of them. Like this one. I'll be Sheamus. All right.
Welcome everybody, and thank you for joining us. I'm Michael Cole, and in my
Oh! You know, it was funny. After I uploaded SummerSlam, I realized I didn't really edit it. Because usually I edit these, you know, like I crop to like what the best parts of the match are. And oh, what a belly-to-belly suplex. But I totally forgot to do that. I don't know why I forgot. I just did. But, oh my god, Jesus, what, what the hell, whoa, Darren, he really does have moves, damn, even when Connor and I were talking, we were saying, like, when we do it together, we're going to, you know, fight each other, and just do it like that for the weeks building up to the pay-per-view, and then once we're at the pay-per-view, we're just going to let it go itself. You know, we're going to determine, you know, the computer, we're going to have the computer determine who wins. Crowd's chanting, Sheamus looks stupid. I mean, you look stupid, but they're directing it at Sheamus. Freaking assholes. Oh! I botched his name. Darren Young getting some offense, but not anymore. Darren Young runs back in the ring. Oh! Damn it, he got to me first somehow. Alright. No, don't worry, man. It's all good. It's all good. Oh! Nice takedown by Sheamus. Celtic Cross connects. If he still has this move, then I'm going to be doing it for the first time in a while. He hasn't done this move in forever. Oh! I only did it because his body is the target, really. It's that orange. Or, yeah. One. Oh my god. One thing I hate that WWE does all the time is that they have their superstars kick out of their reversals. Not kick out. Yeah, kick out. No, kick out of their finishers. Reversals. What the hell? God, sometimes I'm just so bad. But they kick out of their finishers. Like, it's supposed to finish the match, not continue it, you know? And, like, sometimes it gets to you, like, oh my god, like, when AJ kicked out of Cena's moves, like, it's shocking, because that, you know, usually ends the match, you know? And the fact that he didn't is what really got me, you know? And, it's just, they don't do that, you know? And it's like, it's supposed to finish a match. Do that more often. But, so then when people do kick out of finishers, it's like, oh my god, like, how? You know, I mean, like, I don't know how often people kicked out of the Stone Cold Stunner, you know? Anyway, bro kick from Sheamus. Go for the pin, jackass. Thank you. One, two, three, it is over. The Celtic Warrior, Sheamus, wins in his debut match on Blood Raw. And yes, I did skip. I didn't skip replays. I took them off because I hate them. Sheamus is looking good so far on Blood Raw. Anyway, let's go up to our next match. Here we go with our next match. Here comes Paige. Paige fought Bayley last night at SummerSlam. Did not successfully win. Was not successful last night, and that's the reason why she doesn't have that women's championship around her waist. But tonight, Paige is going up against the woman who attacked Bayley after their match. Nikki Bella. And there she is. There's Nikki. The first match Nikki Bella has. Her debut on Blood Raw. She looks pretty happy to be back. Nikki Bella has a chip on her shoulder. She wants that women's championship. We're going to see if she can do it or not. I can tell you right now, Bayley is definitely going to be watching this match. The two ladies are in the ring getting ready for action. Uh-oh! It's Bayley! Bayley got attacked by Nikki Bella after her match at SummerSlam against Paige. The women's champion wants a close look at Nikki Bella's debut match. So I guess I'll be Nikki. Oh! Nice way to start off with a clothesline. Nikki Bella with a huge return at SummerSlam, attacking Bayley after her match. Not the most respectful way to ask for a women's championship match, but you know what? You gotta do it anyway. Whoa! Whoa! Oh! Paige showing Nikki how a dropkick is really done. Shit. Oh, Nikki Bella on the outside now. And so is Paige. Oh, thrown right into the barricade. Look at these punches to Paige. Did I do anything to her? No. Wait, she's not even sitting on a chair. What the fuck is going on? Oh! Oh my god! Oh shit! Let me attack her! Oh, look at Bayley! Bayley now! We've discussed it many times, Michael. Oh! Oh, look. Let's attack Bayley! Oh no! No! Uh-oh, Bayley has Nikki! Oh! Whoa, why did I get... What the hell? Oh, wait. German suplex! Bayley's not even in the match. It's like a triple threat out here. Ref at a count of five. Oh! Bayley just threw Nikki off. Well, that was something, huh? Better not leave, Bayley. No. Think she's leaving. Okay, no, she's not. I'm worried. I want her to see what's going on. Because Bayley needs to see... Uh-oh. A hard throw into the corner. Hey, oh, now there's a chair. Uh-oh. There is so much tension between these two. Oh my god, look at this page! Oh my god, what a punch! Wow. I think Bayley's leaving now. She finished what she has to do. Oh! Head first into the barricade. Oh my god. Oh my god. Paige is just abusing Nikki Bella. Just throwing her. Nikki's hitting head first into the barricade. Oh! Not barricade, into the ring. Ref had a count of six. Nikki Bella's up to her feet though. Oh, and what a clothesline. Nikki Bella's pissed. Nikki Bella is pissed. Bella Buster. What does Nikki Bella have in mind? Oh! That is not pretty. Oh! Oh, wait a minute! No! PTO! I did not skip these, though. Or I did not, not do that. I kept the replays in. One, two, oh, Nikki kicks out! Wow! Ooh, Paige still going after the head. I don't think Nikki can take too much pain. Nikki Bella has her chance. What is she going to do? Oh! My God! Oh my God! Jesus! What a kick! You gotta wonder when Nikki Bella wants to end this. I mean, now it's just pissed off abuse right here to Paige. And what? Oh, tornado DDT! Going for the Bella Buster again! And it connects. Uh-oh. Nikki Bella's new move, TKO! Look at these replays. Oh, wait a minute. She's not finished. Oh my God. You proved your point, Nikki. Oh, another TKO. She really wants to make sure this is over. Obviously, what Bailey did earlier really just pissed her off. This has to be it. One, two, three. Nikki Bella gets the win. Absolutely disgusting, though. It would have been over already. But you know what? I guess she just wants to prove her point. Prove that she is not to be messed with. There's a reason why she was champion for over a year, and she wants to prove to Bailey why. Wow. Well, I don't know what to say, you know? We're just gonna see where this continues. As the weeks go on, as Raw continues this month. But let's head to our next match. Alright. And here comes Big E. Oh my God, I have his stuff from my old universe mode. This is his old entrance and crap. Jeez, I forgot to change that. Anyway, this is Big E's debut match, actually. This is Big E's debut match on Blood Raw. He was drafted last pick for Blood Raw on the SmackDown draft. But he wasn't out and Kofi came out. So it's the first time we're seeing the muscle of the New Day, Big E. So this will be interesting match as he goes one-on-one with Dolph Ziggler. Here he is. Dolph Ziggler. Yeah, that was a cool cash-in. That's still one of my favorite cash-ins. When Dolph cashed in at WrestleMania. Or not WrestleMania, the night after WrestleMania. It'll something be something that the WWE Universe won't forget. It's something I won't forget. Anyway, we got Big E and Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler actually did compete for the draft that was against Bray Wyatt in a losing effort. And SmackDown got the draft pick first because of that loss. Ooh, and Big E and Dolph actually have history together. If you don't remember, Big E was Dolph's bodyguard. Dolph was the big reason. Actually, no, AJ was the reason that AJ Lee was the reason why why Big E's here. But he was here to protect Dolph and herself. So got the submission. This is Dolph Ziggler's move. Oh, but Ziggler got out of it. This will be a brutal fight, ladies and gentlemen. You can already tell because... Oh! Because the announce table is already off. What is Big E thinking? Oh, he's got a kendo stick. Oh, well, look at Dolph now. He has the steel steps. Oh, my God! Did you see that? Oh! Dolph with a reversal, though! Oh! He hit Big E! He hit him again! Dolph is pissed! Wow! Oh, Big E with the reversal, though. Oh! Oh, no. He has the steel steps! Oh, my God! Brutal! I told you this will be a brutal fight! Oh! Did you see how that... Oh my God! I think they were New Day chants right there. That's his signature? I thought it was the move where he does, like, the running on the ropes and then he does the, just, like, lands on him or whatever. Whatever. Anyway, Dolph Ziggler now. Has Big E up. Oh, what a super kick! This might be it! One! Oh, Big E kicked out at one. Dolph can't believe it! His super kick usually finishes people off. Not all the time, but sometimes. Oh, what? Oh, zigzag! I hit my move first. That was bullshit. One. Oh, still a one count. That he has to do a lot more damage to Big E if he thought that was over. Oh, Dolph Ziggler thrown to the outside. Oh my God, what the hell is Big E thinking?
Keep in mind, this is... Watch it.
Oh! Wow! Axe handle from Big E.
These are great competitors.
Oh!
Tremendous gladiators here.
Oh my God, head first into the barricade.
WWE have to offer. Jerry, when Dolph Ziggler debuted on Raw in 2008, it was clear that he was...
What is Big E and Dolph? What is Big E doing? Dolph's just following him. Wait a minute. Not on our announce table, guys. No. Big E, come on. Oh my God. Oh, big ending through the announce table. Oh my God. One, two, 3! Wow! What a win for Big E! That was impressive. Kick this freaking ass. Alright, so... Wow. Let's just head to, the next segment. And here comes the Dudley Boys. Here to address the WWE Universe. The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring. Recently became the tag champions last night. Beating the New Day, actually. In a surprising fashion. I mean, I don't doubt the Dudley Boys. They're a great tag team. But thought the New Day would have more of a fight in them. But we're going to see what the Dudley Boys are wanting to address to the WWE Universe. Alright, boys. Whoa. Wait a minute. What the hell? What's the Revival doing here? Dudley Boys want to address onto the Universe, and the Revival's out here. The recent call-ups from NXT from the draft. There's no telling what these competitors will do in Extreme Rules, but I can guarantee we're about to find out. Watch out here! Oh, he missed. Nobody hold that time.
These competitors will always be looking at ways to finish a maneuver, and when that happens, the complexion of the match can change in a heartbeat.
You're right about that. The entire match can end in a heartbeat if somebody hits their big move. Here's the thing. This match, of course, isn't for the championship, but the champ can't afford to look past this one. If he does, he could lose momentum or, even worse, get an injury. End of story. This one's over.
Football, this isn't good.
And there's another huge shot.
This match will up.
He's in big trouble.
And there's the Russian leg sweep. No chance of staying up right after that one.
Yeah, flat on your back. You've become accidentally horizontal. Well, we're on the move here. Oh, out of nowhere.
Says, top of the morning with the Irish.
And WWE just kicked off. We have a packed house here, and there are personal issues everywhere you look.
Oh, they couldn't find a home for that one.
Well, it certainly wasn't due to a lack of trying, Michael.
How do you sum up Dudley's performance as of late?
Here's somebody who's willing to do just about anything to get to the top. I like it. That's the way it should be. A ton of talent, a ton of ability. Certainly someone to keep an eye on.
And now it is show-off time. Don't waste time gloating here.
Hey, too fast.
to the limit here. Wow, he's still down after that. Remember, momentum and double. Going around the ring with the Irish whip. He's throwing him around like a rubber band.
That was absolutely sick. Ugh. Well, anyway, here is the first ever Raw Champion, Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar is going up against John Cena again tonight. For the reason, Cena, he got destroyed. And, you know, the GM said, well, Cena, because Cena was demanding, not demanding, but he was wanting a rematch. And he said, well, Cena, if you can win against Brock tonight, then you can have another rematch for the championship at Clash of the Champions. And here comes the doctor of Thugonomics, baby. So happy he's back. John Cena, we've been seeing for over 10 years, is not the John Cena we've been wanting. This is the John Cena the world wants again, and that's exactly what happened last night. John Cena came back as the doctor of Thugonomics. Oh my god, don't tell me they're gonna do it again. Oh my god, what the hell? I gotta change it up. Oh man, here we go. Whoa, what the hell? Look at Cena going after the Beast. He is not happy about Brock embarrassing him last night. Oh my god, why is Brock so red already? You can tell Brock's not happy about a possible rematch with Cena. And oh my god, look at the strength of the Beast! And obviously he's not too happy about what Cena was just doing to him. Oh, look at this. DDT! My god, oh my god! This is a fight, ladies and gentlemen! Never seen Cena like this before, ever! He is pissed! Oh Oh my god. This is just a brutal, brutal beatdown right now. Ooh! What a clothesline. Hey, they just mentioned CM Punk. Oh, going for the shoulder tackles, but missed. Oh, Cena's in a dangerous place right now. Okay, no, Brock does not do this. Okay. Oh, wait, whoa. Hey, or excuse me, the FU. One, two, oh, Brock kicked out. Cena is not happy. Going after the ref. Oh, and he hit him. Ooh. Oh, my God. Oh. I hate this move so much. It's so stupid. Look at Cena. He's like, what the hell is going on? Oh, my God. No. Oh, my. This is brutal. Oh man, what a powerbomb from the beast. I think Brock's done. He's gonna take Cena to suplex. Not just yet. He was going to take Cena to Suplex City, but not today. Cena's fired up. Uh-oh, Brock's back to his feet. But Cena got to him first. Oh no, Brock with the reversal. Oh, what a suplex. Not a German suplex like the fans want, but it's a suplex. Cena kicked out at one. Look at Brock. He doesn't know what to do. This is not the same John Cena he fought last night. Oh, Bulldog. Oh, wait. Go for a quick pin. One. Two, three, Cena gets the win. Oh my God, with a quick pin. Oh, look at Brock. Wow. Brock was not ready for that. And he lost. The Doctor of Thugonomics. One, he's getting another rematch. We're going to see Brock Lesnar versus John Cena one more time. Most likely, if we're going to see Brock Lesnar and John Cena at Clash of the Champions, Cena gets one more chance to beat Brock Lesnar at Clash of the Champions for the championship, for the Raw Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of Monday Night Raw. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you tune in next week on Monday Night Raw.